What's up, everybody? It's your favorite Kage, Enigma Kage, bringing you yet another video. This is episode 2 of the Enigma7 series, a new weekly series that we're bringing every Friday at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And guys, last episode did pretty good. I wish the numbers were a little better, but hey, it's a new series and I'm trying to get more eyes out to it. So definitely like the video and share it to your friends. If you're new to the channel, welcome. I'm Enigma Kage. I do a lot of anime content, especially anime gaming. Definitely check out the channel when you have free time and subscribe today. So guys, we all can say we know a person or knew a person that just wasn't into anime. No matter what you said to this person, this is nothing more than a cartoon to them. We've all been there. The concept of anime just doesn't stick with them. They may have seen Digimon, Pokemon, and DBZ within passing, but they never really gave anime a full dive into it. Well, in this episode, I'll be giving you my 7 top starter animes for beginners. These are animes that are foolproof that you give to them, and I guarantee you, a non-anime watcher will appreciate these 7 animes. And you know what, guys? Anime is like food. It is best enjoyed together. Unless you're like me, who enjoys eating alone and watching anime alone. But
whatever.
Let's start off red hot with number 7. Attack on Titan, guys. You can't go wrong with Attack on Titan. The story is easy to follow. It is definitely post-apocalyptic. And everybody who said it's a cartoon will see how brutal a Titan can be to a character. With that loss of hope feeling, I guarantee a non-anime watcher will get hooked on Attack on Titan. Number 6, Cowboy Bebop. You're talking space travel, jazz music, an amazing soundtrack, and a great storytelling. This is what Cowboy Bebop offers the non-anime fan. A great story with cowboys, bounty hunters, all these guys in a fractured world together with great storytelling. Number 5, before anybody be like, what the F, listen up, Yuri on Ice. Yuri on Ice is a sports anime that transcends the boundaries of sports anime with a unique narrative and organic character-driven conflict. It balances out comedy and serious moments with careful maneuvering and scenes and plot points. And it features a gay romance that doesn't override the main narrative, but rather becomes part of it. The art style and story is ever so rich and worth your time. And the ever-growing LGBTQA community will appreciate this show as well. Number 4, Hunter x Hunter. This is when you're really ready to get them into shonen anime. You don't want to start them off with Dragon Ball Z. Too much flying stuff going around. You don't want to get a One Piece because they get intimidated by the number of episodes. And Naruto is a good starter, but I would start people off with Hunter x Hunter. Why? Because the power system is clean and simple. Gon is a lovable character. And the story basically is about a boy who finds out his father is not actually dead, is actually a world-known hunter, and he wants to follow in his footsteps. This will open doors for anime such as Naruto, Bleach, and of course the predecessor, Yu Yu Hakusho. I guarantee you, they don't want to see the flying fights from Dragon Ball Z. They want to see an easy, driven story with great characters. Hunter x Hunter is the way to go. And of course, their dub is pretty good too. Number 3, Neon Genesis Evangelion. Sorry if I butchered the name, I really don't listen to that title. But the plot is complex, which, you know, is worthwhile. You got a full range of humans fighting for survival. You got good mecha battles, and trust me, it blows Transformers and Pacific Rim out of the water. This is something that they might want to see. Trust me, if they like Transformers, they will love this series as well. Number 2, Full Metal Alchemist. And I'm just, you know, going a little story time for you guys. Full Metal Alchemist is the first anime that I took completely serious. What I mean by that is I've seen Yu-Gi-Oh, I've seen Pokemon, I've seen DBZ and stuff like that when I was growing up. But it wasn't until I was my freshman year that I actually got into anime really hardcore. My friend told me about Full Metal Alchemist and told me to watch it. I'm like, I'm so used to power systems and all that other good stuff. And then I started watching Full Metal, which has a great and amazing story using alchemy. And I just thought, like, you know, anytime someone asks me to recommend them something, I will always recommend them Full Metal Alchemist. I will say I recommend watching Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood because it follows the manga more so than the original Full Metal that came out about 2003. So the story is about, after trying to bring back their mother from the dead using alchemy, brother Ed and Alfonso find themselves missing their body using alchemy because alchemy has the equivalent exchange. You see all kind of adventures and you see a great story being told with the relationship between the characters. I'm telling you, this is something that people want to see. Check it out. You will regret not watching this anime. And number one, Death Note. I'm not against the Netflix version.
Oh shit, what is that?
But let's face it, we're trying to get people into anime. I'm not one of the people that's a dub versus sub type person. If that's what your spin is, fine. I like a lot of dub stuff, but I'm mostly a sub guy. If you want to watch the Netflix version, I feel like you're doing yourself a disservice than not watching the original Death Note. It's about a boy who finds a notebook, who writes people names in it, and they die, you know? You watching Light Yagami go from being the protagonist to the antagonist. And then the story is just so good and well told. I recommend that to anybody who's going to start an anime. Out of all the lists, Death Note should be number one on everyone's list to try to get someone into anime. If I'm wrong, we wouldn't have seen a Netflix series. Of course, they're going to try to Americanize it and capitalize off the Japanese Death Note because it is that damn good. I'm telling you guys, be prepared to ask yourself some deep soul-searching questions when watching Light Yagami do what he do the entire series. I just fall off my head, whatever. Anyway, guys, that's it. 7 anime that I guarantee you is foolproof that they will just love. They will fall in love with them. I gave you 2 out of the 7 on this list. Once they get that, they'll start to venture off to stuff such as My Hero Academia, Black Clover, etc. You know what I mean? But anyway, guys, if you like the video, definitely like, share, and subscribe. And check one of these videos out right here. You know what I mean? That helps the channel out a lot. And I'll be seeing you guys next week with another series of 7. See you next time. Peace.